Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. If you create an assembly process, at some point you'll need to bring in new parts. Today, we'll see how you can create a part feeder from scratch. Let's get started. For this video, let's open 06F part feeder and open the Game Boy assembly station. So here you have four parts feeder. So you have one for the battery pack, one for the back plane of the Game Boy, one for the back plate of the battery pack, and one for the screws. If you were to open world and battery pack bays, or top cover bays, or battery pack cover bays, or screw bays, you would find a mechanism here in screw, or you would find in battery cover, in top cover, or in battery pack. So what I did is I simply used a linear axis to bring in new parts one after the other. So here, if you look at, I don't know, the top cover, if I open this mechanism here, I can simply use this here to move up the pack of back cover and bring them, let's say, to the next level so that the robot can actually pick it. I obviously have my Python or my init part position here, which will bring back all the mechanism to their original position. It's the exact same concept as when I was using the conveyor, so I won't re-explain that part. You can go and watch module 4, video 7 and 8. I'm explaining you how this works. It's the exact same concept. With the next part and init part position subprograms. So let's go ahead and create this one here. So I'm gonna go and create a new station, Control N. I will open here my folder and bring in my assembly station. That's the first thing I'll have to do. Starting from here, I will create a frame somewhere here. Doesn't really matter, to be honest. The only thing I really need is to have the x-axis in the right direction. So I'm going to create a frame here, and I will, so this one here is at zero everywhere. I'm going to move it manually so that I can have it here. It's a bit too far, so that I can have it somewhere like this. And honestly, if I can have it like right where the top plate is, that would be awesome. And I'm gonna simply rotate it like this, double click on it, make sure that this is minus 90. I can enter more rounded value if I want. This was 85, eh? Like that, 135 and 970, let's say. Perfect. So that will be my frame top cover, let's say. Perfect. Cool. So then what I need to do is create a linear axis right there. So I can go for utilities, model mechanisms, and robot. I can select my frame cover top as my reference. I can call it here top cover feed, let's say. I will go for, this will be position zero, and then I will move upward. So I will move, I don't know, I will enter a meter of range. I think it's a bit too much, doesn't matter much. Here I won't enter any 3D models because I don't need, I just need to have a linear, a way to move objects up. That's it. I don't need to have anything else following except the objects I want to bring in. So I'm gonna click OK here. It will bring it at this spot here. The only thing I really need to do is select that position here, copy that position here from the frame we created first, and then apply it to this one here. Now I can make this one invisible. I can then create a frame here on top of the mechanism. I can reset its position so that it's at zero, and I will call it cover part, let's say. I can close this here, I can close that here, I can remove these here, can make this one invisible. And now if I move this up, the stack will follow. Okay, so that's great. Now I need to add the part. So let's go back to the folder. We have here top cover. So I can bring in this one here. Great. So I need to have it right here. It's exactly where I want it. Perfect, everything is at zero. Now in reality, this should be a bit different. So I'm gonna just make sure that I figure out the exact best position for it so I can show the object reference frame here. And I can maybe move that here, make this invisible. And here I'm gonna kind of eyeball this one up just a bit so that makes sense. It touches a bit, but not too much. So let's bring it down. So let's say this will be the position of the first part. If you have a specific position where you need to put it, let's go for it. But in this case here, I will go like this. I will then create a new frame here, reset the position, Control C, Control V, and then starting from here, it's the exact same process as what we did for the targets. So let's go 20 millimeters down, bring one here, right click, change support, cover part here. Then I can reset this one here, select these two, Control C, Control V. I can move this one up minus 40, select these two, change support, cover part, select all of those, Control C, reset this one, Control V, then move it down 80, and then change support, convert cover part here. I'm just gonna move that here. You can then Control C again, right click, reset. And then this process is just going faster and faster as you go, because you kind of double up your stack every single time. So this is just faster and faster as you go. So reset here, select all of those, Control C, Control V. That here, that would be great. So I think I just need to add one more here. So what I can do is select all of those, change support, cover part, then select the last one, right click, reveal in three, select it. Here I'm going to create a copy, Control C, Control V of this one here, double click on it, and then I'm going to move down 20 using the scroll wheel in this case. And just like that, I created my stack of parts. So it took just a few seconds, like a minute or 2 minutes or so. So it was pretty fast. And starting from here, I can go and grab my here from Conveyor, my next part file here. So I'm gonna drop it here. Init conf position here. I'm gonna drop it here. This one I will call init part position, and here this one will be next part. So right click, edit Python script, and init next part will need to have this frame here, this mechanism in fact here that we pick, and we just have to change the name of the mechanism here from conveyor to top cover feed. And this will simply bring it back to zero. So I can Control S this, right click, and then edit Python script. I need to enter the same string here, Control V. And here the travel will only be 20 millimeters. So this is how much I need to move upward, Control S. So just like that, if I go and I hide that here, if I go next part, it will move one step up, next part, one step up. And then this way I can pick the parts as they come in. And if I need to reinitialize everything, I can just go init part position, and this slider will go back to its original position. So I did the exact same thing for the screw feeder and for the battery pack and the plate cover. So that's pretty much everything for this video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we will start, we will create a pick and play station using a linear rail and a two-finger gripper. So that will be kind of a way to take on all the knowledge that we gathered in this module and exploit it and use it for real application. So hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.